name is Chechi Arinze, and I'm a fashion designer. I was born in England and spent about 3 to 5 years there before my parents moved us back to Nigeria. Growing up, my mom was a fashion designer. She had a big workshop studio in my house. Like, once I'm done with school, I come home, I'll be going there and I'll be disturbing the tailors, begging them to teach me how to sew. I used to cut their fabric, I used to make clothes for my dolls. The first thing I needed to do was learn how to sew and to cut. So I went to a place called Nobel Afrique. It's a pattern making school. So I learned how to cut patterns, I learned how to sew, and I already knew how to design. It was just interpreting the designs. So I learned how to do that. I get inspired by many things, but I think I get inspired a lot by music. I listen to a lot of rock and alternative music, and for some reason, sometimes when I'm listening to it, the lyrics or something, I just get an idea from the way I'm feeling at that point in time. And sometimes when I listen to music, I sketch a lot when I listen to music. Okay, before I got my own sew workshop and had my own tailors, I used to have to outsource it to tailors who could not understand my sketches. I'd sketch something that I thought was very simple and I'd come back and see something ridiculous, and sometimes I'd almost feel like crying because you don't have to face the clients, and the client doesn't really want to hear stories. Even if it's too narrow, all they know is that they paid you. Workers, it's very hard to find skilled workmen that are diligent and actually want to stay. Some of them don't have good work ethics. They want to resume work by 12 and close by 4. Well, it depends. If it's for a client, the client usually comes with a brief of what they want and where they want to wear it to. So that's where I start from. I sit down with the client and we have a consultation. I sketch and try and get exactly what the client wants and understand the client's expectations from the design. After that stage, I source for fabrics to go with the sketch. After that stage, we do the pattern stage. If it's a design that I'm used to, it's not a big deal. We just use it regular pattern. If not, we have to come up and create a new pattern for it. And then my tailors sew the design, put it together. The client comes for a fitting. If there's any amendments, we do that, and then we finish up the dress. That usually starts with coming up with a concept or theme for the shoot and coming up with a set or a backdrop. After we've done that, then we'll decide on the clothes that we're actually going to include in the shoot. Then we start looking for models. After that, I also start thinking of photographers, because photographers have different styles. So the person's style has to correspond with the shoot that I'm trying to do or the theme I'm going for. And after that, I consult with my stylist to decide on the looks and how we're going to put it together, the accessories. If we need to source for accessories, we do that. That's why I usually do. In my, I don't know whether to say short time in fashion, I've had the opportunity to work with a lot of people. I have the opportunity to work with a lot of brands. Yeah, I worked with Mai on the Dream Wedding Show. I've gotten to feature on Moments with Mo as a young designer. I've gotten Wajet to wear one of my clothes. I've gotten Lala Akindoji to wear one of my clothes. In Nigeria, the clients I wish to work with, I like people that are very fashion forward. So I think I'd like to work with Omomi Akinfesi. I'd like to work with Nkiru Anumudu, because her fashion is always, she's very high fashion and I love that about her, so I'd like to work with her. I'd love to dress Rihanna. I think she would look really good in any of my designs because, as I said, I'm very edgy and so is she. I think the making is a very innovative project because there are not a lot of people that are. It's not just about a competition and then you win a prize and all that. It's also about giving you an opportunity to be mentored by some certain people in the industry. Having people that will tell you home truths about your designs. They're not just trying to flatter you. They're going to tell you, you know, this won't work, that won't work. This is how you can make it in the industry. You don't need to do this, you don't need to do that. It gives a lot of people exposure. I hope continues to grow from strength to strength. I mean, a couple of years, I expect the making to be a very big deal.